It's been a ride. The store is a ride, and there's a lot to it. There's different worlds that collide, and a lot of cliffhangers and important matters as well.
It says it all. This is what people are craving for: more content of representation.
My name is Elodie Jung, and I play Toni de la Rosa on The Cleaning Lady.
Hi, my name is Martha Millen. I am playing the role of Fiona de la Rosa on The Cleaning Lady.
Toni is trying everything she can to save her son, who suffers from a rare disease. She's not in her country. She has to become undocumented. Then she's caught up working for the mob against her will. She's a bit like Alice in Wonderland on a really bad trip. One thing after the other is going to happen, and it's just going to be worse and worse and worse and worse. She's walking the tightrope of morality. Is she doing right? Is she just doing wrong? You know, she doesn't even have the time to think about it. On the other side, she adapts. She has to, because she is a survivor. And so it was really subtle. Like, it was around episode 6 or 7. I'm like, oh, she is changing. She is adapting. Her reactions are different. You know, the writing is brilliant. So that was the meat for me, the juicy part of this journey to embody.
Fiona is a very passionate woman, very fiery and spirited, unpredictable. But at the same time, you follow her journey of empowerment throughout the series. Fiona has so many ups and downs. I mean, you see her in the first episode punching someone, so that already says it all about who she is. It's always wonderful to have those light moments that Fiona brings to the show, because it humanizes her as a person as well. Because, and especially as a Filipino, that's exactly who we are. No matter what situation, there's always time to eat or sing or dance. That's just our spirit. So I really wanted to include that and portray that. It was just so exciting to see that one of the lead roles was actually written for a Filipina. I'm so grateful to Miranda Kwok, who wanted to put that in the forefront and focus, center the family around the Filipino cultures.
We are in the world of fiction. So of course you're going to have this thriller and this cliffhanger element and the explosions. It's kind of exciting to put her in this criminal world. But really, to me, the show is about inviting the audience to feel for this person.
Our relationships throughout the show, I think, are very important, because if you're able to relate to what the family's going through, I think that will bring empathy. And I think that's a really great way to highlight some of the topical issues that we deal with immigration, DACA, on the show, but really grounding it through, you know, family values. And I think that's a great way for people to be open to maybe conversations because of that.
And the show does it cleverly. It's not hammered. It's just nicely presented, and it's inviting the audience to put themselves in my shoes, in Fiona's shoes, in every character's shoes. I can relate to her journey on a personal level, because I am the daughter of an immigrant.
The most important thing was the fact that the show is completely groundbreaking, that we are represented in all aspects, from the writers to the actors and producers. It basically shows how authentic the story is, because it's coming from our own experiences or just our own points of view. The numbers came in about the show being the highest rated show series premiere for Fox in 2 years. And I think it should be highlighted that it says it all. This is what people are craving for: more content of representation. And it's wonderful to be part of that. I'm really excited to see how many other doors are going to open.
Well, there's so much about this show that I care about, and I'm so excited for the world to discover it, and hoping people will like it as much as I've loved being on it. Truly anything can happen in Vegas. I mean, I've only spent 2-3 days there shooting. I'm like, get me out of this place. There's too much going on here.